A woman in Nevada dies from a bacterial infection that was resistant to 26 different antibiotics. A UK patient contracts a case of multi-drug-resistant gonorrhea never seen before. A typhoid superbug kills hundreds in Pakistan. These stories from recent years and many others raise fears about the possibility of a post-antibiotic world. The development of antibiotics in the early 20th century was one of the greatest leaps forward of modern medicine. Suddenly, common illnesses like pneumonia, strep throat, and gonorrhea were no longer potential death sentences. But even in antibiotics' infancy, it was clear that their misuse and overuse could lead to antibiotic resistance and eventually create untreatable superbugs.
The doctor knows that if he uses an antibiotic when it isn't really called for, he may sensitize you so that some future time when you have a really serious infection calling for an antibiotic, it wouldn't be possible to use it.
Here's how that works. Superbugs are the product of simple microscopic Darwinism, the survival of the fittest. You've got a colony of bacteria, and you flood them with antibiotics. Most of the bacteria die, but there's a tiny, tiny chance that a few of them survive. And if you repeat this process with a new antibiotic, those few survivors would now be resistant to two antibiotics. Survive, multiply, repeat. That's how a superbug is born. To prevent superbugs, public health officials have pushed for decades for restraint in the use of antibiotics. But despite their best efforts, antibiotic use and resistance have boomed. In fact, over the last 15 years, antibiotic consumption rose 79% in China, 65% in Pakistan, and doubled in India. Easier access to antibiotics is without a doubt a huge benefit to millions of people. But as antibiotic use continues to spread, the risk of superbugs rises, especially in places with overcrowded urban areas or poor sanitation or cultures of overprescription. And it doesn't matter whether a superbug emerges in Washington, D.C. or Mumbai. If something isn't done to either come up with new, better antibiotics or to stop misusing the ones we currently have, scientists say we could be heading to a post-antibiotic world, one very similar to the 1800s when bacterial infections were routinely deadly. Jason Beaubien, NPR News, Washington. This is Let's Talk, NPR's news explainer show. Make sure to subscribe to our YouTube channel, and please check out our other shows.